Lord tonight. I tell you, church, we can't praise him enough.
That's right,
since we can't praise him enough, right, it's time for the church to wake up out of their sleep,
yes,
to arise and stand up and stand for Jesus and stand for him strong. Let the light shine that is within us, not this outward man, but that inward man that's incorruptible. He's not of a corruptible nature, Sister Dolly, but he's incorruptible. And let this world see who Jesus is.
Amen.
Let them know where their hope is.
That's right.
Lord, I praise him. That's too loud, ain't it? I get excited. I can't help it. You know, it's not an excitement of the flesh, but it's an excitement in the Lord.
That's right.
And sometimes I may get a little bit loud, but I just can't help it. I praise him tonight. I've got lost children out there that needs the Lord. I've got loved ones out there that needs the Lord. I praise him tonight. You know, I love that song. Sometimes it takes a mountain. Sometimes it takes a mountain. You know, Sister Erica, it's took mountains to get a hold of me. You know what the word, if you listen to what the words of the song is saying, Sister Dolly, you know, a lot of people, they'll come up on a mountain and the first thing they want to do is they'll have to drain of the seed of a mustard seed. You can say to that mountain, be thou removed. They're wanting to take the mountains out of the way. God can take the mountains out of the way, but sometimes he'll send us a mountain. It may be a sickness, sis. It may be someone lost. It may be someone needing delivered, but God has sent us a mountain so that we can help those that are without. Praise God. We can't do nothing if we ain't got him ourselves. Too many people trying to work that ain't got the Spirit of God ourselves. There's man called and man sin. It takes God to send you, and it takes God to do the work. You know, we plant the seed. Yes, we do. Another will come along and water it, just like she said, but it's God that gives us the increase. We can't build in this building. It takes God. He's the builder. Because it's a building that's not made by man's hands. But it's God from heaven that's making this city. And I praise him tonight for it. I can't praise him enough for the things he's doing. You know, we got to let that light shine. It seems like the church has been dead for a long time. But it's time the Lord is going to raise them up. We've got to get in a place with Jesus like we've never been before. He's taking us to a place, sissy, and we're going to stand. And he's going to raise up his body. And this world's going to know, Sister Erica, just who Jesus is. It ain't going to be about us, but it's all going to be about him. Man's got his glory too long already. They're wanting God's glory. They're exalting themselves and setting themselves up on a seat in a church house somewhere, making themselves as God. You know, he said that about the son of perdition. What does that tell you tonight, church? They're sitting in buildings everywhere, making themselves to be God. They think it takes their hand to touch somebody for them to get healed, delivered, or anything. I'll tell you tonight, I can't do nothing, but it's Jesus that does it all. I can do nothing, Sister Dolly. It takes him. He said he sent forth his word, and he healed them and delivered them from their destruction. If they're walking in destruction tonight, it's because they got it themselves. You know, God ain't doing a lot of it, but he's getting blamed. But they know that they've been in sin, and they know what they've done to themselves, and they want to say the devil's fighting them, but the devil don't fight, but he's already God. He's after the seed of God. I praise him tonight, church. I can't praise him enough. I love Jesus tonight. I love him. He's done so many things for me, like we've all testified, you know. And Sister Dolly, it don't take a house full for the Lord to move in. It takes two or three gathered together in his name. That's more than me saying the name of Jesus, but that's me being in Jesus and you being in Jesus. It takes that word, being in that word, in the unity of that spirit, and two or three can tear up Manchester town. It don't take a mighty great army. It just takes a few. He didn't choose us because we were many. He chose us because we were few, and because the love of God. Praise Jesus. If we had to be a crowd, we would never make it. If we had to have a lot of money, we'd never get in. If it took going in on our looks, I'm afraid a lot of us would be lost out. We'd never make it in. Thank God he's not going by that outward adorning, but he's going by the adorning that's coming from the inside. It's himself that he's looking at. If he looks at you and he sees anything else, then you better find you an altar of prayer and pray. And that's what the world needs to know tonight. If you're presenting anything besides Jesus, you better find you an altar somewhere, and you better lay this life down. Because we have to die to live. We have to die out of this carnal man and come alive in that spiritual man. He said, put ye on the mind of Christ. We got things coming upon this world that we'll never be able to face off in this flesh. But if we're in the mind of Christ, if we've got his mind, then we've already been made overcomers. When you start looking at the word of God, there's nothing that he didn't overcome and put out of the way. But if we start walking in that carnal mind, then we're going to die just like the rest of the world. Those that won't accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior. Lord, I praise you tonight. Can't thank you enough. I'm going to read a little bit out of the book of Romans. It's what the Lord put on my heart just a little bit earlier. It's Romans chapter 1. We see a lot going on in the world today. But you know, we don't even have to look at the world anymore. All we have to do is come to church and get in a lot of buildings. That's what that message was about. The abomination standing in the sanctuary. They're coming into the sanctuary. Book of Ezekiel says that jealousy was standing in the door. It had come into the most inner courts, and it's a keeping people out. I've never seen a church world like I've looked at today. When I was young, people came together, and they came together for one thing. It wasn't to see each other. It wasn't to lift up some man, but it was to praise Jesus, and he'd be at that all in all. But through the years, people have let down, and they've compromised. They're letting anything go. Well, he's not an anything goes kind of God. He's a one-way God, and he laid out the path, and that's the path we have to walk on. But I'm going to start reading in Romans chapter 1, verse 18. It says, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. Because that which may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has showed it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. Church is without excuse today. You know, there's still things wrong with the church. When he was talking to the churches in the book of Revelation, there was only two churches that he didn't find something lacking with. You know, he told them, thou still lackest. You're falling short of the glory. If he's looking at the church today, he's looking at some people that are falling short. He's giving them a time to turn and repent and get back their first love. But that's what it is. They don't want to love him. They say that they love him, but in their works and their deeds, they are denying him because he does not step out of his word. You know, they will deny him by the works that they're doing. But out of their mouth, they'll say, I love Jesus. You know, he's my all in all. Well, if I'm a loving Jesus, he said, if you love me, then you'll keep my commandments. If you love me, you're going to abide in my word. Because if you don't love, that's the only way that he's going to know that we love him, is that we're abiding in that word. Because when he looks at us and we're abiding in the word, then he's seeing itself, says. He ain't seeing flesh. He's seeing itself. people want to take the scriptures and they want to turn them around to meet fleshly needs. They'll holler, he don't see the flesh, he's only looking at the heart. But he does look at the heart, the soul, Sister Dolly, but he sees in whom you're yielding your members to, and he knows what thoughts are in that heart. He knows what's in there, whether it be of the world or whether it be of God. We're living in a hardened system. You know, it's not just a false church. Anything that's in sin and won't accept Jesus as their Lord and Savior is a hardened system. If you fall into it, then you're doomed for hell. You've got to come out of her, my people. He's getting ready to make a cry through his body that the world is going to hear. Come out of her, my people. They're going to run for help. And some of them, it's going to be too late for because they've denied him one too many times. But you know those that's out there that's never heard. That's never heard. They're going to hear. He said the hour cometh where even those that are in the grave are going to hear my voice. See, they're going to raise up. He's working for a natural, a big natural move of the Lord. I'm looking for a move of God. He's moving and he's all time moving. But I keep looking for him to help this flesh out none. If he helps this flesh out much, then my flesh will probably take me to hell just as fast as anybody else's flesh would. But he's getting ready to do some healing in the spirit. Blinded eyes are going to be open. Lame is going to walk. That didn't know nothing is going to know. That is wise is going to be made foolish. That he may confound them. I praise God that he's getting ready to use his body the way that he is, Sister Dolly. Amen. Sister Dolly, it's him. Amen. It can't be us.
That's right.
Blessed is he that has part in the first resurrection. For then death hath no more power. Amen. Hallelujah, we've overcome. He overcome death, hell, and the grave. Amen. It can't prevail against his church. It can't prevail. His church has prevailed already. Praise God, we're going. And we're going to stand. Just like in the book of Joshua. When he took all of Israel. He said all of Israel. God's getting ready to call his people from all over the world. In parts, wherever they're at. And he's getting ready to tell them. It's time to get back and take the city. It's time to take back what Satan stole. It's time to take back that flesh thing that's killing everybody and let them know who Jesus is. The trumpet is sounding, Sister Dolly. And it's time to raise up. Joshua took all of Israel down and parked them outside. I say par, but he camped them right outside of Jericho. And he told all of Israel, he said, you sit there and you be quiet. We've been in a quiet time, church. The Lord ain't letting us say a whole lot, but he's letting us say enough. They told him, he said, you be real quiet. And the priests are going to march around the city. First day they're going to march one time. Next day they're going to march again. And the third day they're going to do like so until they marched around that city seven times. And on that seventh time, when the trumpet sounds, I want the whole body of Christ to stand up and give a shout. So that means the whole body has got something to do. We can't just sit around and not do nothing for God. He's got to work for the whole body too. And we're going to have to stand up. And we're going to have to profess his name. They're going to have to see it, sis. Too many people professing and not showing already. Too many people professing and not showing already. Because, listen, the wrath of God, back at verse 1, is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteous men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. It was revealed to them. They know who he is. They are without excuse. But yet they still cling to unrighteousness. And we see that a lot. We see that a lot. It says, verse 20. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead so that they are without excuse. But that man, they knew God. They glorified him not as God, neither were thankful, but became vain in their imaginations, and their foolish heart was darkened, professing themselves to be wise, they became as fools. Sister Dolly, there it is. A lot of people you run on to, they'll make you feel about this high, proclaiming and professing that they are wise and that they know everything. But he said that they was professing themselves to be wise, but they became as fools. Thank God I'm a little country girl. I don't know nothing except for what God gives me. Didn't go to school to preach. Don't believe in going to school to preach. I don't believe in it at all. You want to go to school, get back to the schoolmaster. God left us a schoolmaster. He is our teacher. He is the teacher of all things. Who better can you get to teach you than the Holy Ghost himself? You can't go to a college down there and learn anything. You can learn the written letter, but you can't make the Holy Ghost move in it. If the anointing's not there, then God's not in it. His anointing is in everything that he does. The Word, the anointed one, he's in everything that he does. We just got to keep him in everything we do. And if we're abiding in his Word, Sister Dolly, he's going to be there. Thank you, Jesus. 23. And change the glory of the uncorruptible God into an image made like to corruptible man, and to birds, and four-footed beasts, and creeping things. Wherefore God also gave them up to uncleanness through the lusts of their own hearts, to dishonor their own bodies between themselves. He gave them up, it says, to uncleanness through the lusts of their own hearts, and dishonored their own bellies between themselves, who changed the truth of God into a lie, and worshiped and served the creature, this man, more than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. You can't start worshiping the creature more than you can worship the Creator. For which one is the greatest, the creation or the Creator? I will serve the Creator of all things. He done made my way. He don't have to make it. I can call upon him and it's already laid out. Praise God. He is a good God. He's an awesome God. We all know him tonight. And I know that we all love him. And I can't thank him enough, because that's when you can come together in the unity of the Spirit. Can't praise him enough. It says, for this cause God gave them unto vile affections. For even their women, listen, even their women did change the natural use into that which is against nature. And likewise also the men, leaving the natural use of the woman, burned in their lust one toward another, men with men, working that which is unseemly, and receiving in themselves that recompense of their error, which was meat. It was men turning to men and women turning to women. It was as it was in the days of Sodom. So is it now. I don't have to say so is it going to be again, because it's already now. As it was in the days of Noah, so is it now. Sister Dolly, we're at the end. Well, you know the days. We're in that last living days of the great and terrible day of the Lord. People had better get right, and they better get right now. It's time to arise out of sleep, stand up, and speak the name of Jesus over all situations. And then he'll be taken care of. But they're not all going to accept him. Number 28 says, and even as they did not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a reprobate mind to do those things which are not convenient, being filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, malice, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignantly and whispers, backbiters, haters of God, despiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, implacable, unmerciful, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasures in them that do. You know, we're living in a world that's taking pleasure. When they do evil, they're pronouncing it as being good. When good's being done, they're calling it evil. We're living in a world where homosexuals are getting married. It's an abomination to God. If you're guilty of one, you're guilty of all. He said you can't commit one sin and not be guilty of all. But when you're found guilty, Sister Dolly, there's sin in there. Now, we know that the Word of God says, him that has God cannot sin. You know, and people want to take that as a once saved, always saved. But it's not a once saved, always saved sort of thing. If God's living in your heart, if you've been born again, sin has been taken out. What you did back then, you don't want to do it no more, because you are a new creature. You're not who you were supposed to be into this world, but you who you're supposed to be in the kingdom of God. And he's our heavenly Father, and he's raising us up to be like him. When that man child is born, people's got excuses and excuses and excuses. Word of God also says, fail not to assemble yourselves together even more in this time than we did back then. Sister Dolly, they're coming up with every excuse in the world not to come and eat at the table of the Lord, and they're missing out. Well, they're not going to be able to bring him excuse either. He said that they were unexcusable. This were people that know the truth. He said they know the truth, and they held it in unrighteousness. There's a lot of them out there preaching on the TV today that knows the truth, but they won't come across with it because they're going to lose their crowd. Yes, right. They're going to lose their money. Yes, they're going to lose their place on that station. Yes. I'll just tell you the truth about it. We called the Babyville station one time. Years ago, people kept after us when my dad was living, wanting us to go down there and sing. And my mama had been shown about that stuff, so she wasn't bored, but she said she'd call them. And they asked, first time they asked her, was, are you Trinity? And when she told them, no, Jesus is God and that's the way I am, they wouldn't let us come on that station. Now, not too long ago, I guess 5 years maybe, I called down there and I asked them, I said, how can you go about buying time on your station? You know, I wanted to buy some time to see how they went about it that way. When I went to buy some time, the woman told me, well, I'll send you some papers and you can fill them out. And she said, you'll have to send a demo. She said, are you Trinity? And I said, no, we're not Trinity. And she said, well, I'll send you some papers and you can send us a demo and it'll go before the board. So I said to her, Sister Dolly, I said, so I'm going to send you a demo of our preaching, and you're going to decide whether I can pay you or not. You're going to put it before a board, and you're going to let them decide whether you will take my money or not. It depends on what you're coming against them on the TV. If you come against that Trinity thing, then they're not going to let you own that Trinity thing. You know, I know a lot of good people that's on there as far as singing, but they had to get on there one way or another. I know what they ask us. Now, I know some Jesus people that goes on there and sings, but I do know how they got on there. They was told by somebody else. They was brought on there by somebody else, so they never did have to answer those questions. So you see, they had a way around it, but they do sing on there. They wouldn't let us on there because we preached Jesus, and we sang Jesus, and we walked Jesus, and we're going to show the world Jesus. Don't want to walk nowhere else. Ain't got nowhere else to walk. When they all walked off and left Jesus, and he turned to his disciples. He said, "Will you leave me also? I'm going to be like Peter, and I'm going to say, where would I go, Lord? Where would I go? Because we got nowhere to go. Once you've tasted this holy gift, you can't go back. When he gets a hold of you, you can't go back. There ain't nothing back there for us. Everything for us is right ahead.
Amen.
God is good, ain't he? Lord, I praise him tonight, church. I praise him. He's done a lot of things for me. Done a lot of things for me, and he's had to take me over the mountains, through some deserts, and put me in a valley. You know, I always said, Lord, I'm slow, but don't let me go until I hear from you. Don't let me look over it, Lord. Some people want to call it stubborn, but I don't want to call it slow. You know, I want to make sure I hear him, sis. But I told him, and when I heard that song, it just touched my heart. And I thought about all the mountains that he's placed in my life to get me where he's got me today. I'll climb more mountains, Lord, if that's what it takes to be like him. If that's what it takes to reach a lost soul, then I'll take those mountains. I'll face those mountains. And if it gets me down till I have to pull myself up by my hands, then I'll keep on pulling, and I'm going to keep on pressing, because I know what waits for me when I keep right on pressing. We got to keep on pressing, church. That woman with the issue of blood was facing death, but she didn't give up. The doctors gave up on her, but she heard the fame of Jesus. She heard his word, and she knew if she could just touch the hem of his garment. Here she is with an issue of blood. The streets are crowded because everybody wanted to come out and see this Jesus that everybody'd been talking about. They were busy, Sister Dolly, but she didn't let that stop her. Here she has been put on death row, but she said, if I can just touch the hem of his garment. She pressed through that crowd. She wouldn't stop till she got to the hem of his garment. And he knew that he'd been touched. There was people pushing him, touching him from every corner, every way. You know, they were just crowded up on him. But she touched his garment. And he knew that that healing virtue had left his body. He knew that it was her that touched him. You see, you can press on to Jesus, but if you're not pressing with everything that's on the inside, you're not going to touch him. But when you go at him with a pure heart and give him everything, crying out to him with everything that you got, it don't matter how much is in here about you that you're having to press through, he's going to feel that touch at the hem of his garment, and the virtue's going to go out, and the need is going to be met. It might not be met our way of meeting it. It might not be met on our time, but you can know and rest assured God's going to meet the need. And I praise him tonight for it, because he is a need meter. When we seek out the kingdom of God, that kingdom of heaven first, and everything, just like the sister said, everything we have need of is added unto us. Now, we need the Spirit of the Lord to grow up in us, or we need anything. A lot of people take it as worldly things. I tell you, he supplies material needs. He makes a way. I'm going to tell you, Sister Dolly, he's made a way for me a long time. I couldn't make my own way, but it took Jesus to make it. You know, when I get down and I get without, then God's sending somebody my way to meet my need.